A very good morning, children. I hope you have understood this lesson up to now very well, because I am getting very good response in the form of answers and you are completing assignments. That's very fine. So, coming to the lesson we have done in the last part, Newton's second law. In other way also, we can write the expression F is equal to ma, which is mentioned in your textbooks. So once we will do that also in today's class. So the rate of change of linear momentum is proportional to the net force applied on an object in the direction of net force. So, we can write the expression in such a way, F net is proportional to delta P by delta T. So, what is delta P? Delta P you can write in a way, in such a way, what delta indicates a change. This we have done in the lesson motion, where I told you acceleration we can write as delta V by delta T. Similarly, we can write here the same way. Delta P, change in momentum with respect to change in time. So F net is equal to, if you remove the proportionality, the same thing here also, you have to introduce a constant, that is K. So K delta P by delta T. Again, if you assume F net, delta P and delta T as 1, then we can make K is equal to 1. So we can write F net is equal to delta P by delta T. We have learned linear momentum mathematical relation is P is equal to mv. Just we have to introduce a delta, that is on both the sides. So you know, whatever in maths you will do, whatever you are doing, we have to do both the sides of an equation. Similarly, here also we will introduce a delta on either side of the equation, LHS side and RHS side. That gives you delta P is equal to delta MV. So delta P is equal to M, and here M is a constant, it will not change. M is a mass, so it will not change. Velocity we can change. So that is the reason M I have taken out. In the bracket I have kept delta V. So coming to our equation, F net is equal to delta V by delta T. In that, in spite of substituting delta P as M times of delta V. So F net changes to M into delta V by delta T. We know delta V by delta T is equal to A. So I can write F net is equal to M into A. So F net is equal to delta P by delta T also. So we have to remember F net is equal to delta P by delta T. It is a universal formula that can be applied for any system. Any system means, here system means whenever you consider bodies or objects more than two, on the whole we call it as a system. So F net is equal to delta P by delta T is a universal formula, and it is applied for any system. And this formula in the numericals you have to remember. This is also one of the important formula. Whereas if you go with the next equation, F net is equal to ma can be applied for a system with a constant mass. So on the whole, what you have to remember is, sometimes a momentum is given, then you have to use F net is equal to delta P by delta T. If a mass and acceleration is given, then you have to use a formula F is equal to ma. So in this way, you have to remember one more point, is that the weight of a body is taken as mg, that is vertically downwards. And about this gravity, we will discuss in more in detail one of the lesson in Einstein only, that is gravitation lesson. So in a short way, we remember the mathematical equation for Newton's second law of motion, F is equal to ma, that implies m times of v minus u by t. So whenever force can be reduced by increasing the time taken, interaction time, we can call it as an interaction time also, for the change in momentum of a body. So children, we have to discuss about the applications of Newton's second law. in real life situations. And so now the IPL season has already started. So we'll see whether you can see these type of act during the IPL season or any cricket season. I hope boys are enjoying the IPL. So what is the first situation is that? Catching the cricket ball. To catch a fast cricket ball, what a player do? A player pulls his hands backward to prevent injury to his hands. By doing so, the player increases the interaction time. Here, the time during which the high velocity of a cricket ball reduces to zero, then the acceleration of a ball is decreased. Therefore, the impact of catching the fast ball is reduced. That means here the player has to apply a smaller force against the ball in order to stop it. So here the ball in turn exerts a small force on his hands and the hands are not injured. So we can see in the picture how the bowler is catching the ball. So if at all a situation, the other situation, what is that? The ball was stopped suddenly. The high velocity of the ball would be reduced to zero in a short interval of time, that is T. Then the rate of change of linear momentum of the ball would be larger. Then a large force would have to be applied to catch the ball by the bowler. But this leads to injure his hands. So in order to not to get injured his hands, he will do the whatever the act I told you in the cricket ground. So next application of Newton's second law is use of seat belts in the car. The purpose of seat belt is to prevent injuries to the passengers in the case of an accident or in a case of a sudden application of brake. So, in both the cases, the larger momentum of the car reduces to zero in a very short interval of time, resulting in the development of large force, which causes many injuries. Whatever the belt which is present in the car, the stretchable safety belt worn by a passengers of the car, which exerts a force on their body and make the forward motion of the passenger slower. So, time taken by the passenger to fall forward also increases. In this case, the rate of change of momentum of the passengers is reduced, while the stopping force acting on the passengers is also reduced. So, on the whole, they may get away with minor injuries or not at all with any injuries. So, it is advisable to wear seat belts while you are traveling in a car. This is the reason for that. So children, in today's class we have learnt that F net is equal to delta P by delta T. One more representation of Newton's second law and few applications of Newton's second law. With that, I am going to complete one more part of the lesson, Newton's laws of motion or Newton's laws. Okay. I will meet you again in the next online video class. Okay, children, thank you.